Senator Skinner, I want to start off this conversation by getting your reaction to a series of tweets the Legislative Analyst's Office put out Friday afternoon, just discussing the budget and Governor Newsom's projections. And one of the tweets, it's a series of about five, it says, our estimates suggest that there's a good chance that revenues will be lower than the administration's projections. We recommend the legislature plan for a larger budget problem by reducing more one-time and temporary spending. Your reaction to the LAO's assessment of this?
Well, first, the governor, and I think the LAO pointed this out, and I agree, was very wise to take the approach of considering that we are facing a shortfall and we had so much surplus revenue last year, to address that shortfall through delaying some of our some of the new spending that we approved last year. And that was a very wise approach because it doesn't cut into things like our schools, our healthcare, you know, our fundamental services that all Californians rely on are protected. Now, to the LAO's concern that we may have lower revenues, the governor and everyone is clear that we're in a time of economic uncertainty, and yet we're looking at inflation getting better. You know, it's not increasing. So maybe, you know, who knows? We could either have higher revenues or lower, but I think we're prepared to adjust.
Where are you at in terms of dipping into the rainy day fund? I know the governor said, not right now, I'm not looking at that. Let's take a wait and see approach. That was his quote. The Speaker of the Assembly in the other chamber had sort of hinted in his reaction to it, let's sort of look at those reserves because that's why we have them as a state. Where are you at on this?
Well, the great news is we do have healthy reserves, and thank goodness, California voters, the legislature, and the governor have been very wise to set aside money for future real downturns. But I agree with the governor. I don't think we're at a place where we have to tap into the reserves. For all we know, in a year or two, with economic uncertainty, we could face a much more serious deficit. And that's when we'd really want to be able to tap reserves. But right now, we're in good enough shape. And we appropriated such a huge amount. We had $90 billion in surplus last year. And while I would certainly, everything we appropriated that money for are all good purposes, it's hard to spend that amount of money quickly. So maybe delaying some of it is okay. So that's the approach I think I agree with.
Okay, so delaying or some of the items that were discussed, delaying or, you know, cutting, whatever verbiage you want to use in this, the climate spending right. And transportation. I know one of your colleagues in the Senate, Senator Scott Wiener, was not happy. He expressed on Twitter about possible cuts to transportation. I mean, when you're dealing with something like this and you're dealing with a diverse caucus, even though, you know, both chambers are filled with Democrats mostly, everybody wants what they want. So managing something like that, how do you do that?
Well, note, I said that the right approach was delay. I didn't say the right approach necessarily was delay on exactly the things that the governor proposed. So I think that's the discussion the legislature will have. And certainly if we look at the transit agencies in the Bay Area, their ridership dropped so severely during the pandemic, and their, you know, people are still working at home. That ridership has not gone up. But that's a system that we're going to need to, we, all of us Californians, need to rely on for well into the future. And we don't want it to collapse or crumble. So that's an area we may have to look at very seriously. So the governor has proposed where he thinks we should delay or cut, and we'll debate that and we'll see what we conclude. But I think the approach of delay is the right approach.
And it's also important to note that we're very early in the process. This is the initial proposal. Yeah. We will get a May revise and then a final budget by the end of June. So there'll be a lot of negotiations going on in the meantime. You'll be front and center for those. And how is the approach going to be this legislative session? Because, you know, there are a lot of new members that haven't really navigated budget deficits in their positions.
Well, lucky for them, they don't have to face the kind of deficit that I faced when I got elected in 2008, where we were cutting up to 60, 80 billion. We were cutting out of California the same amount that a surplus was last year. But fortunately now, our economy is healthy. We had such healthy revenues last year that we can weather this. And the economic uncertainty is always a little bit anxiety producing. We got to see how it goes, but we're being smart, and those reserves are a great thing for us to look forward to if we face a much bigger problem than we are right now.
And before I let you go, I want to remind our viewers that this legislative session happening in tandem with the special session that the governor called for in December to hold oil companies accountable in a way for gas prices. We've been sort of waiting for some new details on the proposal. I know that you introduced that proposal. Can you give us an update on where this is?
Well, it's the great thing about my introducing what the governor has proposed to date is that it allows the legislature to start vetting it. It allows the public to discuss it. And I think no one would disagree that California's gas prices at $2.60 a gallon higher than any other state, that there's no good excuse for it other than oil companies manipulating our market. And that caused harm to Californians and our small businesses. So we don't want that in the future. We don't want oil companies to be able to just willy-nilly raise our prices. And what the right approach is to try to minimize that, that's the debate we'll have.
All right, Senator Nancy Skinner, we appreciate your time here on Inside California Politics, pulling over on the side of the road in this weather that we're getting right now to give us a few minutes to talk about the budget and other things. Appreciate your time. Drive safe.
Thank you so much. Great to be here.